right, man. We back. Goodfellas Sports TV. And J.R. Smith responds to his wife going to Instagram and like crying and praying because he cheated with Candace Patton. And if you don't know who Candace Patton is, she plays, I think, Iris on The Flash. Very, very beautiful woman. I stand corrected. J.R. Smith and his wife have 3 kids together, not 4, from the video last night. And one of them, back in 2017, was born premature and barely made it. So let's talk a little bit about the situation. Appreciate everybody for checking in. Make sure you hit that subscribe button, bell icon button, share the video. And, his wife, she cried out yesterday. And she was on Instagram praying and praying for JR and praying for the mistress, Candace Patton. But basically, what actually happened was J.R. Smith said they've been separated. He said they've been separated. So he said they're not together no more. So basically, I guess they're in the process of getting a divorce. And he said that she been knew they were separated. And I guess she just looking for some type of attention or whatever she looking to get. But maybe she don't want to get divorced. You know what I'm saying? And if that's the case, and I don't know what she did for them to get divorced, or about to be separated, or what he did, what she wasn't doing. Maybe he was like, you know what? I just don't want to do this no more. You know, or maybe he did something, or maybe she did something, or whatever situation, or maybe he found somebody else and just don't want to entertain a marriage no more. But one thing is that it seemed like she's trying to hold on to the marriage to keep it together for her kids, or maybe for whatever reason she got. What he got to realize is that he got somebody to actually want him, you know, to actually care about him. Because if she didn't care about him, and he had got an IG thought pregnant, or IG thought, you know, knocked up and married her, she'd be like, okay, we separated, and she'd be all on IG with 3 or 4 different other celebrities, and she'd be luring up trying to get half of everything he got. Even if you got a prenup in place, she'd be trying to work around the prenup. She'd be trying to ham him in child support. It seemed like she trying to hold it together, and she really dying for dude. And whatever he looking for outside the marriage, maybe they do need time to separate so he can see what else going on out there and whatever she doing. But if she start doing her and she start bringing other dudes around, their kids, whatever, then he going to try to act the fool and be mad at him. So, you know, I think in every time in a relationship they've been together, they only married since 2016, I believe. So they've been married around 3 years. But it's hard for me to envision to having a thorough and solid marriage in these times. And marriage to begin with just don't seem solid. Like, you get married at when you're 20. Let's just say hypothetically. I don't know too many people get married. You get married when you're 20. And for the rest of the 20, 30, 40, 50 years y'all together, you're not supposed to sleep with nobody else. You're not supposed to like nobody else. What have you really experienced in life? You stuck to committed to one person. It just don't sound natural to me, you know. And I'm gonna really do my study on marriage, because marriage seemed like a one way street. The majority of them benefit a woman, you know. But you want to put your kids in the ideal situation. But for him, at least he ain't got no $2 sleazer. At least he ain't got no IG thought that's trying to take him for everything. Him crying on social media about her taking everything and this and that. He better appreciate the woman that he do got, because she thorough. She actually wants you and don't want to run off with all your money. And don't want to try to keep you from knowing. Now you pressing that part, JR. Well, you once she over you and you damaged her to the point where it's a wrap, then that's when the game started. When she started dating again and having dudes around your kids, and when you scorn her for life, when you marked her for life, you know what I'm saying? She ain't gonna be you gonna be the one crying. See, you dipping in ranch right now, my brother. You feel me? You enjoying it right now. But once she flipped the script on you, and once she actually move on, what R. Kelly say? When a woman's gone bad, when a good woman's gone bad, ain't nothing you can do about it. Yep. So remember, this is a woman that legitimately care about you. Now, you got a little fling going on. You separated. Well, you know, it's just a fling. But, you know, a lot of men don't look at it like that. They look at it at, you know, booty, titties, and beautiful, and she got this. But, you know what? seemed like old girl do care for you and do want you back, but he said they separated and she just basically looking for attention. I'll link the article from TMZ in the description. Don't forget me on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. Reach out to the email if you got business, question, inquiry, sponsorship, video request. Keep sharing the videos. Want to make a donation to the channel? That link is in the description. But the best way to donate is share the video. But hey, let me know what you guys think about the situation. You know, a lot of times you got to appreciate what you got. Because when you ain't got it no more, it's going to be hard to find that actual, that real love. You know, but hey, it is what it is, man. One time for the one time. It's your boy CJ Goodfellas, Goodfellas Sports TV. We're done.